begin working on design element number 2, which is the points. Let's take a look at the finished project. Each one of these vertices is going to be a point that we need to plot. So let's go ahead and begin by working on the points that are here in quadrant 1, where the X and Y values are going to be positive. What I want to also do is to break this quadrant up into 4 equal pieces. We know here would be 0, then up here pi over 2, which is really 1/2 times pi. So I'm going to take that value of 1/2, and then I'm going to divide that by 4, and that's going to tell me that each one of the points is going to be 1/8 radians away from each other. So let's go ahead and put that in place. So here when we look, we have the chart that I've already filled out, and each one of these locations here are going to be 1/8. So we start here at 0. The next radian measure is going to be 1/8 times pi. The second radian measure is going to be pi over 4. Well, pi over 4 is the same thing as 2/8 pi, and then 3/8 pi, and then 4/8 pi, which simplifies down to pi over 2. All the coordinates here are going to be positive. And what we're going to do is we're going to perform transformations on each one of these points. We're going to use a slide. So here where the X value is positive, when we slide here to the left, the X values are going to be negative for everything here in the second quadrant, as you see. Then as we move down to the third quadrant, both the X value and the Y value are going to be negative. So I made those changes here as well. And then as we work on the points here in the fourth quadrant, the points, the X values are going to be positive and the Y values are going to be negative. So let's go ahead and place these points on the graph in Desmos. So let's go ahead and get rid of this here. So the first point we want, let's say that we're going to have an X value is going to be R3, and that's going to be cosine of 0. It doesn't move up or down, so my place in is 0, and notice that our first point is here. We're going to continue working here. The next point is going to be at R1, and R1 is going to have a cosine value of pi over 8, and it's going to have a y value of R1, and that's going to have, multiply that by sine of pi over 8. Whoops, let's fix that. Sine of pi over 8. And we see that second point here. And then let's go ahead and put in the other points here. So now let's go. We want R2, and that's going to be cosine of pi over 4 for the X value. The Y value is again going to be R2. And that's going to be sine of pi over 4. And the last one is going to be, R2. So we're going to be back down at R1. So R1. And we're going to be at cosine of, we did 4 pi over, I'm sorry, pi over 4. So this is going to be 3 pi over 8. 3 pi. Let's put this in parentheses so that the division works better. 3 pi over 8. And let's put in the Y value, R1, sine, put in parentheses, 3 pi over 8. And let's put in the last one, which is going to be R3. And that's going to be, well, the X value, actually the X value is going to be 0, and the Y value is going to be R3 sine, and that there is going to be pi over 2. So those are those points there. Let's slide this out so we can see those points a little better. And we're going to use some functionality here in Desmos, where if I long press, I get this menu. I want to show lines, and I'm going to go ahead and let's just turn those points off. So we'll click that slider here. And we'll see that it's showing the points here in quadrant one. Let's go ahead and put in the points for quadrant two. So let's go ahead and just click the gear and the duplicate. In quadrant two, we know that the x values are going to be negative. So let's change this x value for each one of these ordered pair to have a negative in front. Let's go down here for negative. Over here, negative. And we don't need to worry about the last one because that's beginning with a zero. All right, let's duplicate. Let's duplicate what we have here as we work on the third quadrant. In the third, let's do that again. Press the gear and then the duplicate. In the third quadrant, we know that the x values and the y values are negative. So let's place in, I don't need a negative here because that's a zero. So let's place a negative in front of that one. In front of that one. In front of that one. Let's arrow over. And let's place a negative in front of this y value here. So there we have the third quadrant. Let's duplicate again. And now we're going to work on the fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, we know that the x values are positive and the y values are negative. So let's change all these so the x to be positive. And I want the y to be negative. So let's just get rid of those negatives there and the x negative there. And that's it there. So let's go ahead and slide this back over so we can better see. And let's go ahead and turn off the circles. So now we see we have what looks more like this Captain Marvel logo pulsating. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to place in the lines to connect the opposite sides. And that'll be the next part of this clip.